10,000 years ago, there were only a few million people living on this planet. 9,000 years later, that number had still not exceeded 500 million. Today, only 1,000 years later, a global population of around 6 or 7 billion seems normal, but by 2050, there could be 10 billion people crowded on our pale blue dot. Despite there being 196 countries in the world, a huge amount of the world's population lives in just two of them, India and China. In fact, 36% of all human beings live in one of those two countries. As mentioned, human beings weren't always great at surviving, and Earth can be an inhospitable place. Following the initial spread of humanity from Africa, China and India were found to be some of the most hospitable places for hunting, gathering, agriculture, and survival, primarily due to the climate conditions and available crop choices. With more availability for farming and healthy living, survival rates were higher, while more space and food meant that more babies could be born. In other words, there were already more people living in Asia 1,000 years ago, but there were only 100 million or so more than the other humans in the rest of the world. Environmental conditions and the geography of the world also affected this population breakdown of the planet. There are huge swaths of land that can't be inhabited, such as Antarctica and the Arctic Circle, as well as harsh deserts on every continent where agriculture can't grow. You must also factor in large mountain ranges, tropical rainforests, tundra, and areas with high salt content, where plants can't grow and consistent living is simply not an option. When you eliminate those regions, that leaves the large landmass of the Indochina Plateau as one of the most uninterrupted and viable areas on the planet to grow crops. The choice of agriculture was also a huge factor. Rice-growing and consuming nations tend to have larger populations, as there are far more calories produced in a rice paddy than a wheat or corn field. However, growing rice is a hard business, so having larger families meant a built-in workforce to ensure a good harvest each year. This naturally led to more children and a society with a calorie capacity to support more people. With ongoing advancements in science and medicine, as well as agricultural practices that have revolutionized the way we feed the world, people have begun to live longer. More and more children survive to childbearing age and have families of their own, and the population has continued to grow all over the world. If one-third of the world's population was centered in Asia, namely China and India, 1,000 years ago, it makes sense that roughly one-third would also be located there now. The population growth dynamics and the factors that allowed for larger families and a more abundant food supply are still present in these two population-heavy nations. Essentially, with a higher base level to begin with in China and India, the population explosion of the past 200 years is more prominently seen there. If the experts are right, and we level off at around 9.8 billion people by 2050, I wouldn't suggest moving to India or China. If you thought taking the train was hard before, just wait until 2 billion people live in each of those countries.